Thank you very much, Madam Chair. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, in 2020, we commemorate several anniversaries, including of Helsinki and Paris summits, as the milestone events for our organization, convened in the midst of the Cold War and fall of the Iron Curtain, respectively. This very first virtual Ministerial Council meeting, taking place against a similarly dramatic background, but of different origin, will also feature prominently in the history of the organization. This reaffirms that the world's largest regional security organization and the linchpin to the Euro-Atlantic and Euro-Asian stability remains vigilant and adaptable to the challenging and ever-changing environment. And Croatia salutes this with great enthusiasm. I would like to thank Mr. Prime Minister and Minister for Europe and Foreign Affairs Rama and his able OSCE chairmanship team in Vienna and Tirana, not only for bringing us together today under the unprecedented challenge of COVID-19, but also for steering the OSCE so competently through the uncharted waters of this new viral scourge. Yet, despite all obstacles, we are now looking forward to several important Tirana deliverables. Croatia is very much looking forward to the appointment of the new Secretary General, Director of Office for Democratic Institutions and Human Rights, High Commissioner on National Minorities, and Representative on the Freedom of the Media. Our soon-to-be colleagues will have my country's steadfast support as they embark in their very demanding tasks. The top five decisions are vital for ensuring sound institutional and leadership footing of our organization for the medium-term future. This is excellent news and a much-needed positive momentum for the OSCE. Having said that, protracted conflicts regrettably continue to threaten the security and stability of the entire OSCE area. Croatia reiterates its profound concern about the conflict in Ukraine well within its seventh year. Although the security situation in the East Ukraine has improved since July, the conflict continues to take its toll. This is absolutely unacceptable. We commend the efforts of the Normandy Four, the Trilateral Contact Group, and the OSCE Special Mission to Ukraine. Croatia will continue to actively support the indispensable work of the SMM, operating in a very difficult environment, exacerbated by the pandemic. All impediments that SMM faces, which occur predominantly in the non-government controlled areas, must stop immediately. Croatia welcomes the cessation of hostilities in and around Nagorno-Karabakh following the ceasefire of 9 November. Now the international humanitarian law must be respected and humanitarian access granted for all affected by the conflict. We underline our full support to the OSCE Minsk Group, led by its co-chairs and the personal representative of the OSCE chairperson in office, in their search of the negotiated, comprehensive, and sustainable settlement of the conflict, including on the status of Nagorno-Karabakh. The situation with regards to protracted conflict in Georgia and Moldova remains my government's deep concern as well. Human rights and democracy continue to be challenged in the OSCE area. No nation has achieved a perfect record in the human rights dimension. Croatia therefore calls on all participating states to redouble our meaningful, comprehensive, and sustained efforts of upholding OSCE principles and commitments, including the recommendation made under the Moscow mechanism. Finally, Madam Chairperson, as you all know, last week, the Permanent Council commemorated another important anniversary, 25 years of the Dayton-Paris Agreement for Peace in Bosnia and Herzegovina. The agreement prescribes current constitutional framework of the country with the equality of three constituent peoples being one of its central tenets. This must be preserved and further enhanced, including through electoral reform, to the benefit of security and stability of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Thank you very much.